Restaurants, I want to build a new kiteboard. I want to, you know, I want to open a resort that caters to kiteboarders. You know, what are sort of angel deals and what aren't?
I actually don't have a good definition, because I think ultimately it depends on how you define angel. And if you define angel as somebody with capital, to Naval's point, who's also providing advice, then you could argue that somebody investing in a restaurant who has a background in the industry is an angel in that restaurant. I think from a Silicon Valley perspective, usually it's a technology-driven company or a company that has a strong technology component, which allows that company to reach real scale. And by scale, I mean $100 million in revenue or more. Right. That would be like a rough definition.
Yeah, the one problem all investors face is getting an exit. So generally, most angels won't invest in a deal that they don't think a VC will come into later, because otherwise their investment will get stranded when the company runs out of cash. So many of them look for these larger deals. And then traditionally, most investors, VCs or angels, don't invest in cash businesses because it's too hard to audit and it's too easy for the money to go out the back door. Right. So that's why restaurants tend not to be as popular.
Venture capital investing traditionally has been a low probability business with a high multiple outcome when it does succeed. The thing that's interesting now is that a lot of people are investing and a lot of businesses are getting started that actually aren't very capital intensive to get off the ground, at least right. in the beginning, and might have a relatively higher probability of success than a traditional, you know, high risk venture business. And so you see a lot of companies where maybe they only need, you know, sweat equity or $50,000 to $500,000 to get the product built, get some customers off the ground, and get to a modest level of break-even, which in the business we sort of call ramen profitable, enough to right. buy you a cup of ramen noodles to survive. And I think that's feeling a different type of investing than used to be around before. The opportunity there is that a lot more small businesses, maybe, you know, small being 1 to 10 million in revenue, could be built using that type of capital. The challenge is there's still a hard time getting exits with those type of businesses so that the investors can get their money back. And if the investors don't get their money back, they're going to have a tough time finding the motivation to get in the first place.